It seems to me that all of us should begin as our foundational document with the Constitution. Mm-hmm. And the Second Amendment in the Bill of Rights provides that the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed.
I'm not a sixth grader. Senator, I've been on this committee for 20 years. I was a mayor for 9 years. I walked in, I saw people shot. I've looked at bodies that have been shot with these weapons. I've seen the bullets that implode. In Sandy Hook, youngsters were dismembered. Look, there are other weapons. I've been up, I'm not a lawyer, but after 20 years, I've been up close and personal to the Constitution. I have great respect for it. This doesn't mean that weapons of war, and the Heller decision clearly points out three exceptions, two of which are pertinent here. And so I, it's fine you want to lecture me on the Constitution. I appreciate it. Just know I've been here for a long time. I've passed on a number of bills. I've studied the Constitution myself. I am reasonably well educated, and I thank you for the lecture. Incidentally, this does not prohibit, you use the word prohibit, it exempts 2,271 weapons. Isn't that enough for the people in the United States?
Mr. Chairman.
Do they need a bazooka?
All right, Senator Feinstein is joining us now from Capitol Hill. Senator, clearly you were insulted by what Senator Cruz said. Walk us through your thinking.
Well, I just felt patronized. I felt he was somewhat arrogant about it. And, you know, when you've come from where I've come from and what you've seen, and when you found a dead body and you put your finger in bullet holes, you really realize the impact of weapons. And then as you go up the technical ladder with these weapons, and they become more sophisticated and more the product of a battlefield, and you've got these huge clips or drums of 100 bullets out there that people can buy. When you see these weapons becoming attractive to grievance killers, people who take them into schools, into theaters, into malls, you wonder, does America really need these weapons? My answer to that is no. And so it's based on my experience. And I think, well, the bottom line is we passed the bill out of committee by a vote of 10 to 8. The president has issued a very strong statement in support of it.
You think he's doing enough,
at least
though?
You think
he's doing enough behind the scenes to help you get passed through the Senate?
Well, I think it's now going to begin. I think it's now out of committee. Every Democrat voted for it. Hopefully, we will have the debate before too long on the Senate floor, and we will see. It's going to be my intention to divide the question so that hopefully I want to sit down with the leader. There will be two votes, one on the entire bill and one on the part that prohibits clips and ammunition feeding devices of more than 10 bullets.